Y puppy. What else? What you gonna do? What are you gonna give him? What you gonna do with the box? Good boy. Clicker. I left it upstairs, so we're gonna have to use our yes. Yes, good boy. Yeah, good boy. Good boy. And just rewarding for various behaviors. It's been a while. Yes! Almost got the four paws. Yeah! Party, 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 party! Got four paws in a box. And release. Go search. That's also the foundation of the search game. Yes! Good puppy! Good boy! Good boy! And release. Yes, good boy. Now that he remembers the game, I'm only treating for four paws in. And release. So we'll make it harder by making the box a little smaller. Yes, good boy. So it's way tougher. He doesn't quite fit in this box. Yes, good boy. Good boy. Yeah, good boy. Yes, good puppy. Woo! Feeding while those three paws are in. And I'm going to give him a pause to see if he can get that fourth paw in. Yep. Good boy. Good. Good boy. Try again. Yeah, good boy. Woo! All over the place. Why teaching the box quiet? It can lead to tricks like pack yourself into a suitcase, which you can find on my website with Roo, or it can help teach your dog to manage his legs while he's doing agility so he doesn't fall off things. Hey, that's enough. Quiet. But it can also lead into, thank you, those are mine. It can also lead him into fun tricks like foot stalls, which Roo is working on. And shin stalls, so he can keep his feet relatively close together. Come on, up a little bit higher. As I start to drop my shins away, making that shin stall a little tougher on him. Okay, and off.